Well, I tell you, I tried to warn you, but you wouldn't listen. I mean, come on, man. She caught you with her sister and her neighbor's girlfriend. Oh, you had two of them there, huh? Well, listen, Scotsman, I tried to tell you, do not piss off those female bodybuilders, man. They'll put a hurting on you every time. Oh, wait, the camera's on. Hey, buddy, I'll get back to you. All right. Yeah, sorry about that. I was on the phone with a Scotsman there. Anyway, I'm Mark. Welcome to my home. You're watching the Garage Guy 879 channel. And this is what we're looking at right here is my Ruger semi-auto rimfire handgun collection right here. We got the LCP2, SR22 short barrel, SR22 long barrel, and the rest of these are all Mark IVs. We have the Mark IV target, or is that? No. That is the 2245. This is the 2245 light. Here is the Mark IV target. Here is the Mark IV standard. And here's one I just did a video on recently, the 75th anniversary edition Mark IV. Nice little collection, I think, right here. I'm really proud of it. I took my time, and I think I made some really good choices here. But I think it's time to add on to this collection. And there's one I've been looking at, watching the videos about. And in this box right here, my friends, I have the Ruger Mark IV 2245 tactical version. What do you say we get out here inside the carport on the big red toolbox under the bright light and check it out? I'm sure you're going to like it as much as I do. Let's do this. All right, my friends, here we are out on the carport on the big red toolbox under the bright light. Just too muggy today to go up to the garage, man. It is hot outside. But anyhow, let's go ahead and open this up real quick. Move this little guy out of the way. We turn around, open it up. As you can see, it comes in a really nice carrying case. And of course, you do have all your usual paperwork and things of that sort. Instruction manual and all that. Well, how about this? Ruger 75th Anniversary Edition decal right there. Okay. And we also have the Ruger Phoenix decal. Rest of the paperwork, pretty well standard fare. Let's get all this out of the way. Now, go ahead. Comes with two 10-round magazines. These are pretty nice. I've never had any problem with these before. And spares are pretty reasonable. All right, there'll be another one in there. Here's your safety lock. And here's the washer. And we'll get to that in just a moment. Remove the firearm. And put all the paperwork and stuff. Just put it in the bottom. Plenty of room right there. Get this out of the way. Okay. Now. Excuse me. Let's see what we got here. We'll open this up. I haven't fired it yet. I only took it out of the box at my local FFL. And this is a nice one. This is nice. And it's got some weight to it. I believe it's about 35 ounces. And that's unloaded. Go ahead. Remove the magazine. Second one right there. Chamber flag indicator, we're clear. Let me, well, and the camera's running while that happens. Get out of there, booger. There we go. Now, yeah, we're good to go here. This here is basically a 2245 with a shorter barrel. 4.4 inch. Right here is the 2245 regular size, 5.5 inch bull barrel as well, right there. It is drilled and tapped here on top, but not on the bottom. Okay, so you cannot put a bottom rail on that. And basically the same thing as this 2245 light. You remove the bolt charger and the muzzle brake right there. Remove the bells and whistles. Same firearm practically. All right, same size. Anyhow, this right here, the rail under the bottom, the rail on the top, adjustable back sight, front bladed sight right here, and threaded barrel. And the washer right here, yep, you remove this panel if you decide to. Remove the manual safety lever, replace it with the washer, and then just screw your grip back on over here, the panel. It's not bad. Like I said, it's got some weight to it. Like I said, about 35 ounces to where the light version right here, of minus the bells and whistles, I believe it's about 10 ounces lighter. And man, I can tell a difference. This thing is just solid. And if it's half as good a shooter as this one is being right here, I'm going to be well pleased with it. Now, what do you say we go out here and put the first round through this? See how she does. All right, my friends, here we are. My first shots. Ruger 2245 Mark IV Tactical. Let's put about 60 rounds through this.
Somebody's already out here shooting somewhere, but they're way back in the field. Just fine.
Like I said, I tried to tell you, but you wouldn't listen. And you know what? That's what you get for cheating on a woman that can bench press 425 pounds. No wonder your back hurts. Jeez. Oh, buddy, I love you to death, man, but I just don't know. Wait a minute. The shooting segment's over. The camera's rolling again. Look, I'll call you back after the video. Scotsman. I don't know what to think about that guy. Oh, boy. Well, anyway, you saw the shooting segment. I was shooting from 10 yards back, 60 rounds, no malfunctions, and that was on run-of-the-mill bulk ammo, several different brands, and very accurate, no stovepipes, failures to feed, failures to eject, anything like that. It worked great, and I'm very happy with it, very satisfied with it. And what I'm going to do with it, you see this 2245 light? These are called light for a reason. I'm going to remove all the bells and whistles off of it and put it back the way it came because, well, it's light. And with this stuff, it ain't light. I want a light pistol. So all this is going to go on this just for kicks and giggles. No other reason. See how it does. You know, this is just a plinker, a fun gun, and you cannot go wrong with a Ruger semi-auto rimfire. Now, as you can see here, from since the start of the video, I've done a little rearranging. I had to get another stand right here, hold some more firearms, because this 8-gun stand is now filled up, and I'm putting this between the 2245 and the light right here. Of course, I had to move some over, and this little guy right here, male CP222, had to put it kind of by itself. And I thought my collection would be complete, but call me OCD if you want. But I can't leave this space open right here. I'm going to have to get another Ruger semi-auto rimfire to fill the gap, to fill the void in my soul, as I would say. Anyhow, that's another video for another time. But the topic of this video has been Ruger 2245 Mark IV tactical version. It's got some weight to it. It's very accurate. And it's a heck of a lot of fun to shoot, just like all these Rugers here, rimfire, 22LR. Man, you can't go wrong with one of these. And it's very rare that you get a lemon when one of these is concerned. The older models, Mark IIs, Mark IIIs, Mark Is, whatever, yeah, it takes an act of Congress to disassemble them, clean them, and reassemble them. These here, the Mark IVs, one push button, break it down like a shotgun, no problem. SR-22s and this little LCP-2, very easy to take apart as well, no problems. Gotta love some Ruger rimfire, my friends. Well, I babbled on long enough. I'm Mark, GarageK879. Hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it informative. Feel free to leave any comments below. Something you don't agree with, let me know. Let me explain myself. And then again, I may have been wrong. So if I'm wrong, remember, I'm here to learn as well. All right. I'm going to give Scotsman a call back. Man. Catch you good people later.